More presents Recycling Simplified, sponsored by Republic Services.
All right, on this Earth Day, you can help the planet by simply recycling. But it's important to know what you can actually put in the recycling bin. To help us out, Jeremy Walters from Republic Services joins us now. Good morning, Jeremy. Jeremy, I know this already because we shot the commercial together and I literally blew a whistle if anybody violated these rules. But for the rest of the people, right? Let's remind everybody, with the pandemic, have you seen more people choosing to recycle?
Yeah, you're the recycling referee, that's for sure. But last year we saw an insurmountable amount of recyclables coming through the recycling center. Across the nation, we saw a 63% increase in cardboard alone. And I mean, if you think about what we were all doing last year, myself in particular, ordering a lot of things online, We saw a lot of stuff coming through the recycling center, which is a good thing, actually.
Yeah, for sure. And there are a number of items that you can recycle curbside. Can you run through some of those?
Yeah. So, paper, cardboard, metal food and beverage containers, glass bottles and jars, plastic bottles and jugs. That's it. If it's not part of those categories, it doesn't go in the recycling bin. Throwing the wrong thing in there can actually do more harm than good.
Okay, so what happens if you accidentally put them in the wrong bin, other than me blowing a loud whistle in your eardrum?
If I could only have you in every household at the canteen. But depending on what you throw in there that's incorrect, it has a certain fallout that comes with it. And namely, our food and beverage containers, if you don't rinse those things out and residual food or liquid spills on paper and cardboard, we have to throw that stuff away. Paper and cardboard is great for recycling if it's clean and dry, but if it's soiled, we got to toss it. Another big offender, probably the biggest one, is flexible plastics. We all are familiar with grocery bags or those nice satchels from e-commerce. Because they're flexible, they actually have a tendency to wrap and tangle around the sorting equipment. So those flexible plastics, take them back to the grocery store, but never place the flexibles in your recycling bin.
Oh, yeah. Tangling is never fun. I just when you have your like little earbuds that get tangled around something, it's a pain in the butt. So imagine that.
On a much bigger scale, yes.
Okay, so you talked about plastic bags. What about, you kind of mentioned rinsing out recyclables. Is there anything else we need to know about that?
Yeah, look, it's just a quick effort. I'm not saying dishwasher clean, but you just don't want food or liquid that's pooling up and then potentially spilling on, the fragile stuff. And along those lines, think about a pizza box, right? A pizza box is cardboard, and cardboard is a good recyclable, but again, if it's clean and dry. Bottom half is usually going to be soiled with grease, cheese, and other toppings. If the top half is clean, tear it in half, recycle the clean half, but pitch the dirty half.
And just on a side note, Jeremy, I bet you must be one of those people that really hates windy days when all of our bins get thrown to the other side of the neighborhood.
That can never be good. I don't like wind for many reasons. One maybe being my hair, too.
Exactly. Your job's harder. All right. We appreciate it. And the information is on your screen. It's really a good website to go to because it's hard to remember all that stuff. All right. Thanks, Jeremy.
Thanks, Jason.